I'll start by creating a new project. I'm gonna call it Spring Project 07. And it's gonna have two beans. So the first one I'm gonna call method hooks bean, and it's gonna be in this package. And the second one I'm gonna call post processors bean, and I'm gonna have a driver class with a main method that I'm gonna call Spring App 07. And the Spring configuration file that I'm gonna have here I'm gonna call it springbeans.xml, and I'm gonna drop these jars here that I picked up from my Spring and my Commons logging download, and go to properties and add them to the class path. And now going to my post processors bean, it's gonna implement initializing bean, and by implementing that interface, I'm gonna have to implement the after properties set method, and I'm gonna have it also implement the disposable bean interface, and from that interface I'm gonna have to implement the destroy method. And to indicate that the destroy method was invoked, when it gets invoked, I'm gonna print out this statement. So destroy method invoked. And I'm gonna do the same thing for the after properties set method. I'm gonna print out after properties set method invoked. And to hook up this bean to Spring, let me go ahead and go to the XML file, and I'm gonna have my beans tag. Close it here. So inside it, I'm gonna add this bean. So bean ID is post processors bean, and the class is com.ca.tutorial.spring.postprocessors bean. And to test this before implementing the method hooks bean, I'm gonna go to my driver class, and so all what I'm gonna do is to pick up a ClassPath XML application context, passing in my configuration file, and I'm just gonna close the context. So if I go ahead and run this now, here we go. So I have my post processor bean after property set method invoked, and destroy method invoked. So now let me go to my method hooks bean and implement that. Actually, before implementing that, let me go to my XML file and go ahead and add this bean. So method hooks bean, this is the ID, and the class is com.va.tutorial.spring.methodHooksBean. And so my init method is, I'm gonna have a doInitialize method, that's gonna be my init method, and I'm gonna have a doDestroy method, that is gonna be my destroy method. So essentially what I have here instead of in the post-processor being having to implement these interfaces to get an after property set method and the destroy method, I'm gonna define those init and the destroy method in the XML configuration file, so I don't have to implement interfaces. So let me go ahead and go to my method hooks bean and define those two methods. So the first method is going to be do initialize, and all what I'm going to do in there right now is to print out this statement do initialize init method invoked, and I'll have a destroy method that same thing. All what I'm going to have in there is do destroy method, do destroy destroy method invoked. So let me save all, and I should be able to run it and get, in addition to those two statements for the post processor bean, I'm gonna get the statement from the method hooks bean also. So let's do that. So here we go. So method hooks bean do initialize init method invoked, and method hooks bean do destroy destroy method invoked.